And this is how it starts off, folks. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. A beautiful day. Won't you be my rider? All right, folks, check it in a little bit later. Thanks, bye.
Hey everybody, Life Journey of 50 here. So just kind of, you know, over the last couple weeks, especially last weekend with my trip with my friends to West Virginia, we had a day where it just poured rain down. I think we probably faced, I think it was in my video, probably 1.5 inches of rain out there, probably a couple inches of rain in some parts that we rode through. I guess part of it was is I wanted to kind of tell my personal experience with the gear that I have. And again, I know there's plenty of options out there, but this is the stuff that I had that kept me pretty much dry. If you've ridden in the rain a lot, you'll know that I don't care. It depends. Like if you're in an all day rain, you are going to get wet. I don't care how much of a Gore-Tex suit you have on, all this other stuff. At some stage between stops, taking your glove off, helmet off, any of those things. If you're riding more than, let's just say, 4, 5, 6 hours in the rain, there's going to be certain parts that are just going to get wet. The biggest things, obviously, is, you know, your feet, your hands, those type of things. You just don't want to get wet because you just don't want to get cold, right? So, and in some of my video, I'll talk about that. You'll see some of my parts that I'll piece in from the ride in the rain, give you an idea kind of, you know, what happened here. So I'm actually doing this in front of my Touareg 660. A couple things I want to touch base on is gloves. So I know I did a glove review a while back. If you haven't seen that, I'll leave a link in the bottom in the description. But so I actually started off, I bought the Climb. These are the Badlands Climb gloves. These are fantastic. Kept warm, kept you dry. They've got like a cuffing inside of here that you probably can see. Riding any period of time and then getting off the bike, and if you have to put gas in or you stop at the restroom or whatever it is, you know, your hand's going to come out. There's going to be some wet around here, and the wet's going to go back into the gloves. So I will say that by the end of the day, they did get wet inside. They never fully dried out in the day and a half, but we were going to say initially these were a great glove, and I'm sure that over a long period of time, I mean, and they're brand new, so they're a good solid glove, so I wouldn't say anything bad about them. The next day we rode, we didn't really run into much rain. These are the Badlands as well. These are the kind of shorter ones, obviously. These are just for normal rainfall. These are fantastic. We did run into some rain the next day, and these are great gloves, especially if you're out on the trail, you're doing any, obviously, adventure stuff, because they're not as bulky as these are, and better grip, but they are Gore-Tex and they do keep your hands dry. So again, from Climb, another great glove. And then on the way home, I guess I was smart enough, because I've done this for a while, and I should say a while, a little over 18 months, but I got 36,000 miles on my bike and did a lot of conditions over the last 18 months. And I would tell you, these gloves I had in my glove review, and these are the Revit gloves and winter Gore-Tex gloves. And on the way home, these were instrumental. These were absolutely fantastic. So, again, knowing what the weekend conditions were going to be like, I packed 3 different gloves, and they actually came out well. I know some of my compadres that rode with, they didn't have extra sets of gloves, and they were still having some damp gloves. So I would always say, make sure that you pack the right stuff for your trips.
And I've got the Badlands Pro 3. This was new. This is something that I purchased specifically for this type of weather and just all around. And it was fantastic. It's heavy. The Gore-Tex, it did not get wet.
There's a reason why you spend a lot of money for good quality gear, and this is expensive. No doubt about it, this is very expensive. I will leave links in the description below, but I think the jacket alone is like $1,600, $1,700. The pants are $1,000. So you can see $2,500, $2,700 bucks just for the suit. But, and I know people will say, oh, I can get frog talk. I can get all, I get it. You can spend money however you want to spend it. This is just what I chose to invest in because I feel like this gives me the best option for a lot of different things throughout my riding. And yes, you can layer it up. You can layer other things up. You can wear different pieces, put water stuff over top. I didn't like that aspect of it. I wanted one thing that I could just put on and be, you know, ready to rock and roll, and I didn't have to pull out other stuff or put liners in and all this other stuff. So that's this. And again, I'm blessed because I can get this stuff. It is expensive. This is fantastic, the Badlands piece. So again, I will leave links in the description below. So now I'm going to move on to a couple of things. Boots. So I have the CD boots. Didn't get wet one time with these. And I've got actually, and again, very fortunate. I got a couple pairs of the CDs. And I've never had a problem with any water getting into my boots. And they are, I will say this, they are expensive. I think they're $450. Again, I'll leave a link in the description, but they're like $450. But they're worth it. Again, you can buy lesser boots. I actually have a pair. I have the Forma. And these are the Evo, this is their top of the line Evo, Terra Evo boot. And this is actually my second pair. My first pair actually leaked. And these, if I was in longer periods of rain, I've been in creek beds and stuff like that with these. And my socks have come out a little bit damp after these. And these are supposed to be waterproof as well. So although these are a great boot, I still would recommend them. But if you're in an all-day rain and stuff like that, now, some of my buddies have toucans. They swear by those. I've never had a pair of those. But the CDs, I've had no issues at all with either pair of them, and they keep my feet dry. So absolutely fantastic. So out of all that stuff that I'm talking about in the rain, your gear, what you do, baggage. I have the Moscow stuff, as you guys know, but I will say one of the reasons why I switched to the hood, and this is obviously off a cap, one of the reasons why I switched to the hood versus the, if I think I have it here, hold on. No, I don't. I have the other one, but it you have to put the sleeve over top of the Moscow. And I just like the fact that you didn't have to deal with that. And no water ever gets into that hood piece, so that's fantastic. The big thing, and I'm going to bring the camera over here. These, hippo hands. Folks, I'm going to tell you right now, if you can get a pair, get a pair. Because these things are absolutely fantastic, and they're about $175, and all they do is, you know, they just kind of go on here like this, you know, and that's it. Put your hands in here, you can control all your things. Best $175 I've ever spent on anything for waterproof. This blocks the wind on your hands. It won't keep you completely, it won't completely dry, but these are waterproof on the outside. So again, water hits it and keeps on going. When you're facing the rain that we faced, yeah, you will see puddles. And I think you saw probably one of my videos, I did this and water came down. But to keep the wind and all the excess rain and stuff off your hands, these hippo hands are fantastic. I'll leave a description, link in the description. So, but I never had a heated gear piece ever last year. And then everybody kind of talked about, oh, it's nice to have a heated gear. I will tell you, when it was 29 degrees and we were riding back last week, and I think you guys saw maybe some of that video, there's this company called Field Shear. F-I-E-L-D-S-H-E-E-R, Field Shear. And it was just a three-quarter vest pullover, and has a little battery here that you put in, and you can get, you know, other batteries, plug it in, and it has hot, it has four different settings. So you got kind of a cool, a lukewarm, you know, warm, and then a super hot, or, you know, like a hot. But that's the first time I ever used heated gear, and I didn't use it when it rained, but I used it on the way home when it was snowing in 29, and that was good. I would tell you that if you do get any heated gear, I highly recommend that. I have a jacket there that I haven't wore, but if it's any indication of what this piece was, this winter will be a little bit more comfortable riding than any other time. So that was kind of the pieces. Again, cold, rainy, especially when it's raining a lot. The rain gear stuff is outstanding. I haven't, you know, like I said, not complaining at all. I mean, you're going to get wet. I don't care if you've got Gore-Tex, unless you're just completely bundled up and you never get off your bike, you don't take your helmet off, don't take your gloves off, none of that stuff, you're going to get wet. But how wet do you want to be? And this gear that I found kept me the driest I've been. And in just in normal rain, it's been fantastic. It doesn't get wet. I've never had any issues with just like some normal, you know, some showers here and there. But when you're riding for 4, 5, 6 hours straight, you got to have some decent gear. You're going to be like a swamped rat. So, but anyway, so yeah, I just wanted to share that with you. I'll throw some video in there, show you kind of what it is. But I would say Hippo Hands, by far, best $175 you can make an investment in. Good gloves, good boots, and some type of rain protection out there. Again, you don't have to go to the extremes. I'm sure that there's some different options out there that I'm not aware of or aware of, but there's different options out there. I just choose these. So again, my basics for it. Hope you enjoyed it. Gives you a little something to think about, and stay safe out there. Winter's here. I'm in Ohio, so we're battling already an early winter, but it is what it is. So take care, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye-bye. Don't forget, like, subscribe, and hit that notification button. I greatly appreciate it. Take care. Bye-bye.